Sing a song full of the faith that the dark past has taught us. Sing a song full of the hope that the present has taught us. Facing the rising sun of a new day begun, let us march on till victory is won.
In 1910, the Havre de Grace Colored School was built on Stokes Street and Alliance Street and provided education for primary school-aged children. Although high schools for white children existed in Harford County since 1896, Harford County policy provided education for African-American youth only through the 8th grade. As a result, colored students seeking a secondary education had to travel to Baltimore, Cecil County, Philadelphia, and other locations to obtain a public high school education.
Since there was no high school in Harford County for African-American children, my father and mother had to send my oldest sister to live with an uncle. He lived in Wilmington as well as in Pennsylvania. So it meant that she was separated from most of the family members for a period of time. Then my oldest brother, Percy, had to travel to Cecil County every day for high school education.
In 1924, prominent African Americans took up the cause of education equality. Most noteworthy were the efforts of Mr. Clayton C. Stansberry. Mr. Stansberry was one of the greatest advocates for the education of African-American children in Harford County. Mr. Stansberry, Mr. Vandella A. Williams, and other prominent African-Americans led the effort to establish a countywide parent-teacher association for colored schools. As a result of Mr. Stansberry's and the Color PTA's efforts, the county agreed to establish the first public high school for African-American students. In 1930, a four-room brick building was erected adjacent to the existing 1910 white-framed building structure. This new portion was the Havre de Grace Colored High School. The first African-American high school principal was Mr. Leon S. Roy. Although African-Americans had a new school in 1930, the county did not provide transportation to the school until the late 1940s.
Because Havre de Grace Colored was the first black high school. And the interesting thing about the black high school was they built it in Havre de Grace, but provided no transportation. If people did not live in Havre de Grace or close, or what some people did was if they had money enough, they would rent from somebody so their kid could go to high school. Or if they had relatives who lived in Havre de Grace and were willing to take them, that's how they got to high school. And that's why my parents didn't get to go to high school, because there was no transportation and they didn't have anybody to live with, and their parents couldn't afford to pay room and board.
I am the only one in the family where my parents did not have to spend money for transportation to go to school. All of the others had to catch a train. I was fortunate, being the last child in the family, so that by that time, the Board of Education did provide bus transportation.
Some buses carried both black and white students, but black students could not sit with the white students.
I sat on the step of the bus.
You couldn't even sit on the
chair.
Couldn't
even sit in a seat, but he had me sit on the step.
The Throughout their tenure at the colored school, students had to rely on outdated and secondhand textbooks and equipment handed down by the schools attended by white children.
We had hand-me-down books from the white schools. Some had no backs on them, and we never did have a science book. But the Mr. Chauncey Hurst would stand up with the one science book, and our parents, as few, just little money, would buy us these composition books, black and white speckled. And he would stand and just read the lesson, and we would write it and write it. And that would be our science book.
We didn't have the books and stuff that Havre Grace High School had, and we only lived two blocks from Havre Grace High School. That was all white school, and we couldn't go there.
Despite the limited access to quality educational material, Mr. Roy and the teachers endeavored to ensure that students had a first-class education.
Chief used to tell us, I don't care if you go to Yale or Jail, you're gonna learn how to read and write and do the things that you were supposed to do. And that always stuck with me, and stuck with many of us.
It's amazing how we still triumph, and I have to give the credit and allegiance to our teachers. Our teachers knew what we were going to face. They knew what they faced, and so they really taught us. We were well prepared.
Although we had secondhand books, they never really let us forget how important an education was. We were taught what was going on around us, and we were taught to respect ourselves. Although we knew we could not go to certain places, we were still given that spirit of how important we were. We were told that we could be the best at whatever we did.
Just as sports figures like Jackie Robinson and Jesse Owens helped to break the color barrier, sports also played a significant role and placed Havre Grace Colored School on the map. Although they did not have a sports facility, Havre Grace Color School was highly regarded for their athletic prowess and improvisation.
We had no place to train for track. We trained on the streets and we trained at the park.
Our track was a road. In the middle of the road, we had lines, and that's where we ran, up and down the road.
Students at the colored school were also privileged to have Langston Hughes, an African-American poet, novelist, playwright, and social activist, to grace the hallways of the HDG Colored School.
Yes, I probably was maybe 8 or 9 years old. And at the time, we used the basement where the library was and where they would have maybe some small concerts or activities in the basement of that white part of the building. And as children, we would sit out in the well outside, and we would look down there and listen to what they would open the windows, and we could hear what was going on. I tell you, he was probably one of the most handsome men you've ever seen.
Langston Hughes, a member of Omega Psi Phi Fraternity Incorporated, was a close friend and fraternity brother of the school's principal, Mr. Roy.
Mr. Leon S. Roy was our principal. He used to always tell us that he said, I'm going to bring Langston here. He said, Mr. Roy, you don't know Langston Hughes. All of us said that because we really didn't know. But we didn't find out till later that he attended Lincoln University with Langston Hughes. And they were roommates at one time, and also fraternity brothers, the illustrious Omega Psi Phi Fraternity Incorporated.
The first graduating class from Havre Grace Colored High School was the class of 1932. In 1954, Havre Grace Color Schools, both elementary and high school, were moved to 201 Oakington Road and were combined and renamed Havre Grace Consolidated. There, Havre Grace Consolidated housed all grades from 1st through 12th. 8 days after Havre Grace Consolidated opens its doors, the landmark Supreme Court decision, Brown v. the Board of Education, ruled that sanctioned segregation of public schools was a violation of the 14th Amendment and was therefore unconstitutional.
I remember, I was in college at the time. Mm-hmm. I remember we were just rejoicing because we thought it was going to take effect immediately. Yeah. Talk about disappointment.
Oh.
Talk about, you know what? The only way Harford County integrated their schools each time, it was a lawsuit. Not voluntarily.
Right.
It wasn't until 1965, 10 years after this landmark decision, that schools in Harford County were integrated. The school year 1964 to 1965 would mark the final graduating class of Havre Grace Consolidated School. Currently, the school is named Roy Williams Elementary after the former principal of Havre Grace Consolidated, the late Mr. Leon S. Roy, and the former principal of Bel Air Central Consolidated, the late Dr. Percy V. Williams. The naming of the school was not without controversy.
So, at any rate, when they built Havre Grace Consolidated, the effort went out again to have it named for Leon S. Roy, who was the first black principal in Harford County and had been the principal of Havre Grace ever since it was built. It was built in 1930. And so then, of course, they didn't want that, so there was so much protest that they decided that they would name it Roy, which was that principal's last name, Williams, which was the Central Consolidated principal's last name. And so now when new people come in, they think it's named after a man named Roy Williams.
Despite the many challenges, the story of the Havre Grace Color School is one of perseverance and determination by the students and faculty, many of which went on to achieve success in their personal and professional lives. Now, almost 90 years later, we honor the legacy of these men and women who made extreme personal sacrifices to provide an opportunity for African American children to obtain a quality education. We pay tribute to their invaluable service and dedication to a cause greater than themselves. That is the cornerstone of the values that we as a community still hold sacred. So let us stand together as a beacon of solidarity and commitment to keeping our community strong and to carry on the legacy of those who came before us.
That sometimes there are battles that are more than black or white. And I could not put down my sword when justice was my right. Make them hear you. Go out and tell the story to your daughters and your sons. Make them hear you. Make them hear you. And tell the men the struggle we were not the only ones. Make them hear you. Make them hear you. Your sword can be a sermon or the power of the pen. Teach every child to raise his voice, and then, my brothers, then will justice be demanded by 10 million righteous men. Make them hear you.